Hey everybody, and welcome to part 6 of this game creation series. So in this part we're going to be looking at the objectives. So let's go ahead and create a new blueprint. Let's right click, go to blueprint class, add an actor. Let's name this objectives, or objective 1, since we're going to have more than one of them. Underscore blueprint, double click this and open it up. So all we need now is a collision, so I'll go to components. Let's type collision, and we can use any one of these, but I'm going to use a box collision. Now I'm just going to drag this up, then compile it, then go to the event graph. So let's go ahead and get rid of the event tick. We can keep these two. So I'm going to start with the event begin play, since we need to cast to the third person. And again, we've done this a few times, so you probably already know what's coming. Let's drag this out, cast to third person character. Then from the object wildcard, drag this out, get player character. And then as the third person character, just drag this out, promote to variable. Then go ahead and rename it. I'm just going to comment this, move out of the way. So now we're cast into the third person. We can use any variables that are inside the third person. We don't actually have a variable yet, so let's go ahead and create one. Close this down, open up the third person character blueprint. So this is the line trace. I'm just going to comment this. This was from a previous video. If you want to check out any of the previous videos in the series, go ahead and click up here. So let's just comment this. So in this blueprint, all we need to do is create two variables. I'm going to go to the variable panel, click add new. Then we can rename this player objectives. Now if we go over to this panel over here, we can change the type from a boolean to a text. Let's also make it editable and then compile it. And if we want, we can give this some default text so we can see what's happening. So I'm just going to write objective title. Then what we can do, we can right click on this one and just duplicate it. And I'm going to rename this player objective description. And again, we can just change this. So now we have these two variables, we can change what's inside the variables with different objects. So for example, when the player walks into a trigger box, then we can change the objective. Or when the player interacts with an object, then it can also change the objectives. But let's go back to the objective one blueprint first. So I'm going to go to the variables and grab that player character that we created. Get player character. And then we want to drag this out and then set player objectives, so this one, plug this in, then whatever text we put into here will be the new objective. So since we're going to be copying this blueprint, what I want to do is just drag this out and promote it to a variable so we can actually edit the text outside of this blueprint. Let's rename this. Player objective title, compile it. This can be empty by default, but we also want to make sure it's editable. So let's go back to the player character, drag this out, and we're going to do the same thing for the description. So we want to set player objective, and we can select this description, connect this up, promote this to a variable, and just rename it. And there we go. And then we probably need to do one more thing, but let's just test this and see how it looks. So now in the viewport, we can just grab the player objective, drop this in. We can rescale this if we need to. And then if we look over here, we can see we have the player objective title and the description. So just for this little test, let's bring this box forward. And then the title will be find key. And then here we can just describe what the objective is, what the player has to do, maybe a hint, something like that. That's just very basic. Now when we play this, nothing's going to happen since we've not actually told the HUD to display some text. So I'm just going to go back and then let's open up the HUD blueprint. So it's the same way that we displayed text with the counter. We made this piece of text display whatever the variable is, and we're just going to do the same thing for the objectives. So we could go over here and find some text and then drag this in. But since we already have some text and it already has the properties that we want, I'm just going to duplicate this. I'm going to reposition it. First, let's change the anchor point, top right. And then let's go to text. And then for now, I'm just going to type objective just to see how big everything is. Now, one thing you should keep in mind, sometimes the objective titles might be quite long. If they are quite long, for example, objective title long. So if you've got a long title, that will eventually go off the screen. So if we compile this, play this now, so we can see it's just going to be cut off the screen. So what we can do, if we just go back, if we scroll down, go to where it says wrapping, and we can just choose auto wrap text. So now it's going to wrap and move the text down. So now if we move this over, we can actually choose where it will start to wrap from. So now any text after this will just be added to a new line underneath. Now let's scroll up, find the content, the text, and we're just going to create a new binding. And we can rename this now since we're going to have a few of them. So I'm going to click this one. I'm going to right click, choose rename, player objective title, something like that. So now we need to get the variable to plug into here from the player character. And if you remember, we've already cast to the third person character. So we can just scroll down and find the variable player character. Grab this, get player character. And then drag this out, and we want to get player objectives and just plug that in. Compile that. I'm going to go back to the designer. So now the objectives work. If you want to display the description, it's just the exact same thing, just changing the description. But I think it's going to be a bit too much text on the screen if we have both the objectives and the description. So what I'm going to do in the next part, we're going to be creating the journal, which is going to display the objectives and the description. So let's go ahead and see how this looks. If we press play, we can just see it says objective title. Then if we walk over the trigger box, it now says find key. So what we could do, we could go into the key blueprint and then just add a variable to change the description and the objectives once it's been picked up. Or we could just create another objective blueprint. So now anytime you want to add a new objective, we can just right click on the objective, duplicate it, and then rename this to objective 2. Then we can just place it in the scene, change the objective title and also the description. And then if we play this, so we go to the first objective, go to the next one. Now the problem we'll have if we go back to the first objective, it just changes back to the first one. So we don't want that to happen. If we go back, go to the objective blueprint. So just after here, we can destroy actor. Compile it and test it. Try and find where that objective is. So there we go. Let's just get rid of this second objective. So now this objective is to find the key. Once we find the key, once we pick it up, we want to create a new objective. So instead of going to objective 2, what I'm going to do is inside the key blueprint. So key 1, let's go ahead and open this up. Let's just move this out. So before destroying it, we actually want to set that variable. So let's grab this out. Set player objectives. And then we could do the same for set player objective description. There we go. And just like before, we're going to drag these out and create variables. So I'll rename this. Make it editable, compile it, do the same for this one. And that's it, that's all we need to do. Now if we select the key blueprint, now you can see we have the variables here, so once the key's been picked up, we can just change this to open the front door, something like that. And again, some sample text here. Press play. So the first objective will be to find the key. Then once we find the key, now we can see we need to open the front door. I'll probably just add another objective here, maybe objective 2. We want to make sure it's behind the door. Let's change this to so that's pretty much the objectives done. It's very simple, and I'm sure there's a lot more complex things we could do, but simply pushing the character from one place to another, or when the player interacts with something, the objectives will change. So the next video is definitely going to be a long one, since we've got quite a few things to do. So hopefully you enjoyed this video, or at least found it helpful. If you did, be sure to give this video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.